Hello students, in present video I am going to explain 8th problem from general lesson. This question I am taking from Telangana State Telugu Academy Inter First Year Accountancy Test Book. But this video is useful to all commerce students who want to know about general topic. First 7 problems videos are available in description box and in iCard. I request you to watch those videos first, then only you can understand present video. Let us start the problem. First transaction is on 1st April 2019. Transaction is started business with a capital of 90,000 rupees. Who starts business? Owner. Owner name is given in the question. Sudha is the owner of this firm. While writing journal entry, there are some steps. First step is, in every financial business transaction, there will be minimum 2 accounts. These 2 accounts we should identify. Second step is grouping. And the third step is applying the double entry principles. First step, identify the minimum 2 accounts. From Sudha, cash is coming into the firm. While writing journal entries, always we should analyze each and every transaction from firm's point of view. So your assumption is you are an accountant of this firm. Cash is coming into the firm. Therefore, cash account is one account. And this cash is brought by Sudha. Sudha account is another account. Second step, grouping. Grouping means we should identify whether this cash account is a personal account or real account or nominal account. Account is divided into 3 types: personal, real and nominal. If any account is opened with a person name or firm name, it is known as a personal account. If account is opened with one asset name, it is a real account. If any account is opened with expenditure name, loss name, income name and gain name, it is a nominal account. Cash account. Cash is an asset, no? It is a real account. Then Sudha account. With a person name we open this account. Therefore, it is a personal account. Grouping is completed. Now last step is apply the double entry principles. For real account, double entry principle is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming into the firm, therefore debit cash account. For personal account, double entry principle is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here Sudha is giving money to the firm, she is a giver. Therefore, credit Sudha account. Now, owner's name we should not record in the books. When owner's name come in credit, instead of writing owner's name, we should write capital word. Then final entry is cash account debtor to capital account. Narration is being business is started. On the same day, another transaction is purchased goods from Tarun on credit 20,000 rupees. Purchase transaction is given. We should observe 2 points. First one, what they purchased? They purchased goods. How they purchased? On credit. So, from Tarun, firm purchased goods on credit. Goods are coming from Tarun. 2 accounts are goods account and Tarun account. Why I am taking person name here? Because it is credit purchases. In future, we should pay money to Tarun. To the firm, Tarun is becoming a creditor. We should remember that. We should open Tarun's account in our books. Therefore, person name we should consider here. Goods, asset, no? Therefore, it is a real account. Tarun account is a personal account. Then real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, debit goods account. personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Tarun is giving goods, he is a giver, credit his account. When goods word comes in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write purchases word. Then final entry is purchases account data to Tarun account. Narration, being goods are purchased on credit. Second day transaction is sold goods to Sonu 30,000 rupees. When sales transaction is given, 2 points we should observe: what they sold and how they sold. Firm sold goods. As customer name is given to us, we should understand that this is credit sale. To Sonu, firm sold goods. Goods are going from the firm. And on the same day, Sonu is not paying cash. Cash is not coming from Sonu. Two accounts are Sonu account and goods account. Why I am considering person name here? Because it is a credit sale. Sonu becomes a debtor to the firm. In future, Sonu has to pay 30,000 rupees to the firm. Sonu is liable to the firm. Firm should remember that. Therefore, in firm's books, we should record that Sonu is a debtor. In firm's books, we should open Sonu's account. Then only we can remember that in future, Sonu has to pay amount to us. That is why we are taking Sonu account in journal entry. Sonu account is a personal account. Goods account. Goods means asset, no? It is a real account. Personal account rule: debit the receiver, credit the giver. Sonu is receiving goods. He is a receiver. Debit him. Real account rule: debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going, credit goods account. When goods come in credit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is sales transaction, no? Write down sales account. Then final entry is Sonu account data to sales account. Narration, being goods are sold on credit. Third day transaction is purchased goods from Raghav for cash 25,000. Purchase transaction is given. We should observe 2 points: what they purchased, how they purchased. Clearly is giving that firm purchased goods for cash. Even though supplier's name is given, it is not credit purchase because for cash they purchased. Now, from Raghav, we purchased goods. Goods are coming. And on the same day, we gave money to him. Cash is going. Two accounts are goods account and cash account. We need not to consider Raghav name here because this is cash sale. We need not to record his name in our books. Both are assets. Both accounts are real accounts. Real account rule: debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, debit goods account. Cash is going, credit cash account. When goods come in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is purchase transaction. Write down purchases. Then final entry is purchases account data to cash account. Narration, being goods are purchased for cash. Fourth day transaction is sold goods to Tony for cash 16,000. Sales transaction is given. 2 points we should observe: what they sold, how they sold. Firm sold goods for cash. Even though customer's name is available in the question, we should not consider that because we got money from him. We need not to record his name in our books. We need not to remember that he is a debtor to us. He is not a debtor because he paid the money immediately. Cash is coming from Tony and the goods are going from the firm. two accounts are cash account and goods account. Both are real accounts. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming, debit that account. Goods are going, credit that account. When goods come in credit, instead of writing this goods word, we should write sales. Then final entry is cash account data to sales account. Narration is being goods are sold for cash. Fifth day transaction is goods returned to Tarun 5000 rupees. Return transaction is given. Returns are of two types, purchase returns, sales returns. Observe the transaction, goods returned to Tarun means firm is returning goods to Tarun. Means once firm purchased goods from Tarun, on this date firm is returning goods to him. So these returns are purchase returns. Two accounts are Tarun account and goods account. Tarun account is a personal account. Goods come under asset, no? It is a real account. Apply the rules. Personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Tarun is receiving goods. He is a receiver. Debit Tarun's account. Real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going, credit goods account. When goods come in credit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is purchase return transaction. Write down purchase returns account. Then final entry is Tarun account data to purchase returns account. Narration being the entry for purchase returns. Sixth day transaction is bought furniture for cash 15,000. Purchase transaction is given. We should observe 2 points. What they purchased, how they purchased. They purchased furniture. Fixed asset name is given. Firm purchased furniture for cash, clearly is mentioning. Seller's name is not available. Take one imaginary name X. From X, we purchased furniture. Furniture is coming. In return, on the same day, we paid cash to seller. Two accounts are furniture account and cash account. Both are assets. Both come under real accounts. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Furniture is coming, debit that account. Cash is going, credit that account. Instead of furniture, don't write purchases. That rule is applicable only for goods. If fixed asset name is given in the question, we need not to change the word. Then final entry is furniture account data to cash account. Narration being furniture is purchased for cash. 18th day transaction is sold goods to Sudeep 12,500. Sales transaction is given. We should observe 2 points. What they sold, how they sold. They sold goods. Customer's name is given. Means it is a credit sale. From the firm, goods are going to Sudeep. And this is credit sale. So Sudeep is not paying money on 18th date. Cash is not coming. Two accounts are Sudeep account and goods account. I'm taking customer's name as an account here because customer is a debtor to us. We sold goods to him on credit, no. In future, firm has to receive money from Sudeep. Firm should remember that. Therefore, in firm's books, we should open customer's account. That is why we are taking Sudeep account here. Sudeep account is a personal account. Goods account, goods means asset, no? It is a real account. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Sudeep is receiving goods. He is a receiver, debit him. Goods account, real account. Real account rule is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going, therefore credit goods account. When goods word comes in credit, instead of writing that word, we should write sales word. Then final entry is Sudeep account debit to sales account. Narration is being goods are sold on credit. 19th day transaction is goods returned by Sudeep 2000 rupees. This is a return transaction. Returns are of two types, purchase return and sales return. See the transaction, goods returned by Sudeep. Sudeep is returning to the firm. Means once firm sold goods to Sudeep. Now Sudeep is returning those goods to us. Means these returns come under sales returns. Goods are coming from Sudeep. Two accounts are goods account and Sudeep account. Goods come under asset, no? It is a real account. Sudeep account is a personal account. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, debit it. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Sudeep is giving goods to us, he is a giver, credit his account. When goods come in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is sales return transaction. Write down sales returns account. Then final entry is sales returns account data to Sudeep account. Narration being the entry for sales returns. 25th day transaction is cash received from Sudeep 5500. This is settlement related transaction. Sudeep is liable to us. He has to pay money to us because in past we sold goods to him on credit or we have given loan to him. Now he is settling his account by paying 5500 rupees to us. Cash is coming from Sudeep. Two accounts are cash account and Sudeep account. Cash is asset, so it is a real account. Sudeep account, with the person name we are opening that account, no? It is a personal account. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming, debit cash account. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Sudeep is a giver, credit his account. Final entry is cash account data to Sudeep account. Narration being cash received from Sudeep. Last transaction is on 28th date. Goods taken by Sudha for domestic use. Domestic use means for personal use, for household purpose. Who can take the goods like that? Sudha, owner. From the firm, owner is taking goods for her personal use. Two accounts are Sudha account and a goods account. Sudha account is a personal account. Goods come under asset, no? It is a real account. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Sudha is receiving goods, she is a receiver. Debit her account. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going, credit goods account. Owner's name we should not write in the books. So instead of debiting owner's name, we should debit drawings account. Similarly, we should not write goods word, no? Goods are coming in credit, but we should not write sales word or purchase returns word, because this is not a sales transaction, this is not a purchase return transaction. Then what to write? When we purchase goods, we debit purchases account. From these purchased goods only, owner is withdrawing some goods for her personal use. means purchase account balance decreases. When we are purchasing, we are debiting purchases account. When we want to decrease some amount from purchase balance, we should write that the purchases on opposite side, means on credit side. Therefore, instead of writing goods word, we should write purchases. Then final entry is drawings account debtor to purchases account. Narration is being goods are withdrawn for personal use. This is all about 8th problem. Hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you.